Matching sets of clothes made right here.
Better not have a problem with his friend. Hey, get yourself out of there.
Gonna need all your money, big man.
You got a big problem.
Oh, that's it!
All right, boy. What happened?
My horse collapsed. I don't know why. It's my friend's. My leg's all numb. Please,
I'll
hurry.
See what I can do.
Yes. Yes. Just lift as hard as you can. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Well, thank you. You saved
sure.
me. Oh, that was
okay.
Good.
Sure.
I could have been stuck here and starved or eaten. Oh, you poor, dumb animal. Oh. What'll I tell Mildred? Well, thank you.
You need a ride home, ma'am?
Oh, yes, mister, please. Thank you. Do you know Valentine? I live there.
No problem. Come on, boy.
Would you mind? There's not space enough for me on the horse. I don't normally travel this far alone, you know. I was off inquiring about a possible new line of work. I'd borrowed a friend's horse for the trip. See, my husband... Well, it's just me and my boy now, and it's hard to find work.
I'm sure it is.
A good opportunity. That's what I'm looking for. Not much work for a woman with a boy to raise. I won't work in no saloon, but I've got sharp eyes and quick hands. I was hoping to get a job working as a seamstress. A wealthy man said he'd pay me for the work.
Sounds promising. Also doesn't sound real.
Oh, you may be right, I suppose. He said he'd provide room and board for me and for my child. He wanted to meet me first.
I'd be careful with offers like that, ma'am.
I can't afford to dismiss offers like these, even if they do seem... odd.
Just be careful is all I'm saying.
I may not have another opportunity like this. Now I'll have to pay Mildred back for her horse.
It sure sounds like you're in a hard position.
You finding me is the only good thing that's happened to me in a long while, sir.